When we moved to Bangor, literally by accident, I had gone to Queen's and mature student, graduated in the June. We moved to Bangor, and then I got a job in Bangor. So we actually moved because our son was at school here, and we were living in a house on the Prince Tower Road. And I was on the phone to my aunt in Scotland one night, and she said, "What number are you?" And I said, 35. And she said, "Can you walk out into your front garden and look across the road to the left? Can you see a wee small cottage called Lantern Cottage?" And I said yes, and she said, "You lived there when you were a toddler, with your mum and dad for a while. It was my granny and granda's place. They owned a hotel in Queen's Crescent, and I ended up back on Prince Town Road."
Brilliant. Oh,
So I don't know, can I say I'm from Bangor?
yeah, that's great.
Yes, I left further education the end of last January. It was a bit of a lead-in time though, because I knew I was going to be taking voluntary exit. I had to make the decision in the August previous to that. So I was very aware that I was going to be self-employed. I sort of thought I might be at home a lot working. And going from being with people and talking all day to being on my own. So I was leaving the house one day to get the train, and I left a program with my son and said, "There's this choir thing happening. I can't decide whether I should join it or not because I'm not really into big groups of people." And I left him my credit card and said, "You decide." So he texted me about half an hour later and said, "You've joined the choir." And there's not anybody that you'll speak to that hasn't said it has literally changed their lives.
Is that right?
Yeah. Well, to say that I have a group of friends for life is not an understatement. And everybody sort of said the same thing. Everybody lives in and around Bangor, but it's very hard to connect. And it just needs that one thing to connect people, and that's it. So I started retraining. I already had a psychology degree, counselling qualifications. So I studied dietary counselling with a place in Dublin. I've got my qualification in nutritional therapy. I've just finished my professional cookery diploma, so I'm now a qualified chef. So what I've done is I've put it all together by accident, I have to say. A year ago I couldn't have really predicted. So I'm sort of doing a mix between doing private events, like for open house choir, where people pay money to come on a kind of one day course, and then the other half is kind of community-based, working with Belfast,
you were telling me about that.
Which is very hugely rewarding. But to see people's relationship with food, what they eat, their lack of ability to shop, cook, eat good food, is it's terrifying. If people could see at community level, the health implications that are waiting for us, it's terrifying. I had a group of girls recently who did a 6-week program with me, and they left able to cook a roast dinner. Well, that was one of their kind of on their wish list, but I misjudged it really quite badly because they only had 2 hours to cook and eat. So I sort of thought half roast chickens would be the way forward, and I brought whole chickens with me, and it was just one of them cried at the sight of it, at the thought of touching it. And it was only one brave girl sort of said, "I'll have a go at kind of cutting the chicken up into joints." It worked out okay, and they all were so pleased with themselves for cooking this dinner. The Cedar Foundation had a co-program with us with a group of autistic teenagers, and I haven't felt sort of reward like it from work for a very long time. Some of those kids had really poor levels of kind of social interaction and functioning, and on the last night they did a 3-course meal for their friends and relatives. And every one of them did their part, every one of them cooked something, every one of them served something. And that was brilliant. And I've been really lucky. Somebody sort of said to me last March, "How does cooking, nutrition and teaching?" And it turns out it actually goes together pretty well.